Hi everyone! Today in this video, I'm gonna show you how to design a fair calendar using the Blazor Scheduler of Syncfusion. Let's take a real-time example of flight ticket availability. So what's the first thing that comes to mind when you think of flight availability? With no doubt, you will look for the lowest airfare, right? So won't it be cool if the lowest prices of all available flights can be viewed in a single calendar? Of course, yes. So in this video, first, we'll see how to create a month calendar view, and then I'll walk you through the steps to design an airfare calendar. And finally, I'll show you how to display the lowest airfare on each day, and then highlight a date that has the overall lowest price. Now, let's deep dive into the step-by-step creation of an airfare calendar. I'm going to create a Blazor Web Assembly app, and for that, I should have .NET Core SDK latest version. And next, I should have either VS Code or Visual Studio 2019 installed in my machine. In this video, I'm gonna use Visual Studio 2019 for creating the Blazor Web Assembly app. So let me open the Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project by choosing the Create New Project from this dashboard. From the listed project templates, I'll choose Blazor app and click Next. Now let me configure my project by giving it a unique name, My Fair Calendar. And then click the Create button to create a new project with default configuration. Next, I'll be asked to choose the Blazor project type. So here I'll select the Blazor WebAssembly app. Now all is set. So finally, let me click the Create button to create an empty Blazor project. Now I'll tell you the steps to add scheduler to this empty project. For that, I need to install the Blazor Scheduler NuGet package of Syncfusion into my application. So, I'll open the NuGet Package Manager by right-clicking the project and choose Manage NuGet Package. Then, under the Browse tab, I'll search for syncfusion.blazor.schedule and install it into my project by clicking this Install button. Now the package got installed, and you can check under the Dependencies Package folder to see the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler being added into it. So as a first step, let me open the imports.razor file. And here I'll add the namespace, syncfusion.blazor.schedule, to start using the scheduler component. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. So for that, I'll open the program.cs file and first include the namespace, syncfusion.blazor. And then within the async main task, let me make a call to the addSyncfusionBlazor method. The next important thing to note here is the valid license key registration, for which I need to make a call to the registerLicense method. Here I've used the trial key to start using the Blazor components. Now the final step is to refer the CSS file into my project from the NuGet package. So within this www root folder, I'll open the index.html file and refer the Bootstrap CSS under the head section. All right. Now everything is configured, and it is time to add the scheduler component. So I'll navigate to the index component under the pages folder. And here, let me remove the other tags first. Then I'll add the scheduler component using the sfschedule tag, and also set its initial tValue property to object, which is nothing but the type attribute. Now let me run this application. And here you can see the empty scheduler displaying 24 hours. And by default it is shown in week view. So let's move on to the next step on how to customize the scheduler look to display only the month view and also to display the airfare on each day of a month. First, let's display only the month view on scheduler. To do so, I need to define the schedule views property, which accepts the array of scheduler views. Here, inside the schedule views tag, I'll add a single schedule view for displaying month view. And now when I run this application, you can see the scheduler displaying only the month view. We have the empty month view now, so the next step is to display the lowest fare details on each day of this month. These lowest fare details, I'm gonna display them as customized appointments over the scheduler. To do so, first I need to define the data source for scheduler. So I'll add the code section now, and then start to define the appointment collection with flight details. Let's assume that the flight data includes the information such as departure and arrival time, airline name or ID, fare, and so on. So first I'll define an example class with a name flight data. Here, the fields such as ID, start time, and end time maps the default appointment data fields, but the other two fields, airline ID and fare, are the custom fields to be added to the appointment data. Now I'll start to generate the list of appointments, that is flight data, for this entire month of April 2021. Let me create a public method of type list of flight data and name it as generate flight data. And inside this method, I'm going to generate and return the flight data objects. So before I start to generate the random data, let me explain how I'm gonna consider the logic here. Just imagine that there can be n number of flights available on every single day. So here, for the demo purpose, let's consider there are three airlines, say Airways 1, Airways 2, and Airways 3, running on every day with different prices. So our goal here is to compare and find the lowest price among these three airlines for each day of a month, and then display only least fare data on every individual month date cell. So here you can see the date cell April 1st, 2021, displaying the Airways 2 name with the lowest fare value, $257. So in this way, we are going to compare and display the lowest fare details on every date cell of this month. Here, for the demo purpose, I'm gonna generate the random flight data objects with the required fields. So, now inside this generate flight data method, let me define the flight data of three airways for the first day of month alone. Then I'll loop through the other days of April month and create the random objects, generating three appointments per day for an entire 30 days. I'll also return this collection at the end. Now I'll override the onInitialized method, and within it, I'll make a call to the generate flight data method. So, before that, let me create a list variable flight data source, and then I'll assign this method name, generate flight data, to it. Next, I need to assign this flight data source to the event settings property of scheduler. For that, I'll add the event settings tag. And to its data source option, I'll assign this flight data source. Also, let me change the t-value of scheduler from simple object to the type of model class bind to it, that is flight data. Now when I restart the project, you can see the scheduler displaying three appointments per day, with an indication plus two more text on every cell. So now we should filter and display only the flight data with least price on each date, instead of displaying all the three appointments on every date cell. So now let's start to write a code logic to achieve that. I'll define a public method of type list of flight data and name it as filter by fare that receives the list of entire flight data as its parameter. Now inside this method, first I'll group the flight data based on date. Then I'll loop through these dates and query the only appointments that are present on the current iteration date value. Next, I've sorted those single day appointments based on its fare value in an ascending order. Finally, I'll take the first object from this sorted collection and add it to a new list collection. So, the same process continues for the entire April month date collection. And at last, I'll return this final filtered flight data. Now, inside the generate flight data method, before I return the collection, I'll introduce a new list variable filter collection and make a call to the filter by fare method by passing this collection variable. I'll return this filtered collection at last and save the changes. And now, when I run this application, you can see the scheduler displaying the single filtered appointment on every date cell. You barely see any text over the appointments, since we haven't assigned anything to the appointments subject field. So, now let's start to customize the look of these appointments. To customize the look of appointments, I can make use of the event template option. So, within the schedule view tag, I should define the event template, and inside this space, I can add any kind of customization to the appointments. As I already have my own design to display over the appointments, let me paste it directly here and explain you. You can see the context variable here, using which I can access all the flight data fields within this template design. Here I've planned to display only the fare value, airways name, and its appropriate images over the appointments. So I have added appropriate HTML elements with custom CSS class name to achieve the required design. Also, I made a call to the couple of methods here, getAirwaysImage and getAirwaysName. So let's see what these methods return. I'll move on to the code section now, and here, let me add the code definition for those two methods. Within the getAirwaysName method, you can see the AirwaysName is being returned, based on the Airways ID, and in the same way, getAirwaysImage returns the CSS class names. Now I need to write the style definitions for all these CSS class names within the style tag. So let me add a style tag after the code section and add the appropriate CSS styles for the entire template elements inside it. You can refer all these styles from the GitHub example link, which I've shared in this video's description part. So let me save the changes now and run it. And here you can see the scheduler displaying template content over the appointments, and you can also notice that only the least price flight data is shown on each day of a month. All right, finally, now I want to highlight the overall lowest airfare. Not simply highlighting, but I also want to indicate the best price text and a thumbs up font icon at the top right corner of a day cell with the overall lowest price. So first let's see how to add the best price text and an icon to the cell. To achieve this, I'm gonna make use of the cell header template property. So within the schedule view tag, just like the event template, now let me add a cell header template. And inside this template, I'm gonna display the text and icon now. Before that, first I should know the date, which has the overall lowest price value. So to retrieve that date, let me move on to the code section, and here, I'm gonna define a new variable, lowest fare date, of type date time. And then within the filter by fare method, before returning the final data collection, let me sort that collection in an ascending order first. And then, I'll assign the start time of this first object to the lowest fare date variable. Now I know the date, which has the overall lowest price of a month. So within the cell header template, first I should display the dates on each month cell. This is mandatory here because, whenever I define a template for cell header, the design that we pass from this template will completely override the default items displayed over the header element. So, here within the cell header template, let me copy-paste the template design, which I already have and will explain you now. As I said earlier, using the context variable, I have accessed the date value of currently rendering cell and displayed it over the cell header. And then I have introduced a condition to compare the lowest fare date value with the rendering cell's date value. And when a match is found, I have added an additional span element displaying the best price text. Next, to display the thumbs up icon, I've added an additional span element with eIcons class added to it. To this best price icon CSS class, I've added the content code for that icon inside the style tag so that the relevant thumbs up icon will be displayed over that span element. Now when I run this application, you can see the best price text and the font icon being added to the cell that has the overall lowest price. Next, to highlight this entire cell with a background color, I can make use of the onRenderCell event, which triggers during the rendering of every scheduler element. So I'll define the schedule events tag, and within that, I need to mention the T value as flight data. Next, let me add the onRenderCell event and assign the handler name as RenderCellHandler. Now inside the code section, I'll define the handler code, where I need to check for the month cell type. And then I also need to check for the overall lowest fare date and set the appropriate CSS class name to it. You can look at this CSS class definition here within this style tag. So here you can see the background color is being set to light yellow to highlight that particular cell having the lowest fare value. Now all is set. And before seeing the output, I want to make the scheduler read-only, and I also want to prevent the pop-up window that opens on clicking the cells or appointments. So to make the scheduler read-only, I'll set its read-only property to true. And then to prevent the display of pop-up, I'll add the onPopUpOpen event with a handler name. Next, inside the code section, let me define the handler for it and assign true to its cancel option. Okay, now everything is ready, and let's look at the output. Here you can see the highlighted date cell, indicating the overall lowest price. Also, when I click or double-click on the cells, the pop-up window is not opened. So that's it. You learned how to design a fair calendar using the Blazor Scheduler now. All right. Now let me summarize some of the important points which we have learnt so far. We have seen how to add a Blazor Scheduler of Syncfusion to a WebAssembly app. And then we saw how to customize the Blazor Scheduler and display it as a fair calendar using its built-in properties and styling options. I'll stop here. And you can get this working example from the GitHub link, which is shared in the below description part. You can also let us know in the below comments section if you need any clarifications or additional customizations with this fair calendar. If you really find this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you for watching.